Hey guys, welcome to my channel Electrical Hub. Today we are going to understand the equation of capacitor in series and capacitor in parallel. So if you don't have any idea about capacitor, please do refer my previous video which is based on capacitor, what is capacitance and what are the factors affecting capacitance. So basically you will get an idea about how a capacitor works, okay? So please do watch my previous video for that. So that you will get an idea about capacitor. Okay, so let us begin with the video. So first I will explain you what is the equation of capacitor in series, and then I will explain you the equation for capacitor in parallel. So in first case I will take three capacitor and connect them in series. Okay, and then we will derive the equation. Okay, now I am taking three capacitors, C1, C2, C3. Okay, and now this is switch, suppose, okay, and a voltage supply is given to them. This is C1, C2, C3. This is voltage supply, this is switch S, okay, current I is flowing through the circuit, okay, and I will also draw an equivalent capacitance series, CS, okay, this is CS means addition of all these capacitors, CS is known as equivalent capacitor of series combination, okay. Now, as soon as this switch is on, what will happen? Current will start flowing through these capacitors, okay? And as the current flowing through each capacitor is same, what will happen? Each capacitor will have a same charge Q, okay? Each capacitor will develop a same charge Q. But the voltage across each capacitor will be different. That's why I'm writing V1, V2, V3 for each capacitor, C1, C2, C3. Okay. Now the voltage for each capacitor is different. We know the basic formula of V is equal to Q by C. So taking this formula into consideration, we will get the equation as V1 is equal to Q by C1. Then V2 is equal to Q by C2, V3 is equal to Q by C3, okay? Now if we see this diagram, we will get this equation V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now this total V is what? We can write it as Q by CP, this is, sorry, CS. Q by CS means, why CS? Because capacitor in series, okay? And for V1, we will write Q by C1 plus Q by C2 plus Q by C3. Okay. If we take out it as a common, we will get 1 upon CS is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. If there are n number of capacitors connected in series, then the equation will be 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 up to 1 upon CN. So, we can see that the equation for capacitor connected in series is given by 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 up to n number of capacitor connected in series. Okay, if there are two capacitor connected in series, then the equation will be 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 is equal to 1 upon CS, which will be C2 plus C1 upon C2 1 upon CS. So, CS will be C1, C2 upon C1 plus C2. Okay. This is the equation when there are two capacitors connected in series. Okay. So, you can directly use this formula and solve the numerical also. Okay. Now, we will solve the equation for capacitor in parallel. Now, I am taking three capacitors in parallel. I'm connecting a voltage supply to it. This is C1, C2, C3. Now as soon as the current I flows, what will happen? Charge will be developed across each capacitor. Okay, but as the current is divided over here in each capacitor, because capacitor are connected in parallel, the charge will also be divided. Okay, therefore charge is Q1, Q2, Q3. But the voltage across each capacitor in parallel will be remaining same. Okay, this is equivalent capacitor of parallel combination, CP. Okay, now we know that the basic formula is Q is equal to C into V. So by observing this figure, we can write as Q1 is equal to C1V, Q2 is equal to C2V, Q3 is equal to C3V. Now Q is the addition of Q1, Q2, Q3. So we can write Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Now write, equate this equation in this given equation. So we will get C1V plus C2V plus C3V, and Q is CPV. Okay, so finally equivalent capacitance of parallel, we will get C1 plus C2 plus C3. Okay, this is the equivalent capacitor of parallel combination connected in parallel. Okay, if there are n number of capacitors, then C1 plus C2 plus C3 up to n numbers. This is the equation. Okay, so we can say the potential difference across each capacitor in parallel combination is same, that is, which is equal to V volts. So the total charge on the parallel combination is equal to the sum of charge on each or individual capacitor. You can see Q1, Q2, Q3. So the charge is the addition of charge acquired by the each capacitors. Okay, so this is the equation for capacitor in parallel and capacitor in series. Hope you understand my video. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel if you like my video. Thank you guys for watching this video.